Hello, in this video I'm going to show you how to upgrade the HP BroBook 4540S internal hard drive into an SSD. Now this method will work with any other laptop. It just depends on how you can open it and swap the hard drive. Now this machine is 4 years old and it starts running pretty slow right now. It has a pretty powerful Core i5 CPU running at 2.5 GHz and an AMD GPU, and it has 6 GB of RAM, but the only bottleneck is the hard drive. It's an old Western Digital 1 TB hard drive, and right now I start noticing it's running pretty slow. Now what do you need is an SSD, of course, and you will need also a hard drive caddy. Now what this does is it allows you to add another hard drive in the DVD slot, so you remove your DVD drive and swap it with another hard drive. Now I'm gonna use this external hard drive enclosure to copy the system into this new SSD. Now you can use the caddy, the DVD caddy, to copy the system to the SSD. However, I have this here extra, and it's much easier than to take the laptop apart twice to copy or to clone the system. Now I'm just gonna open it here and remove this old hard drive from it and swap it with the SSD. Then I need to connect the USB 3 to the laptop. And now the SSD is connected to the laptop. We're gonna go now. Once the SSD is connected to the laptop, you need to right click on start menu and choose disk management. It will show you all the disks that are connected to your computer. Right now I already have the SSD cloned. It's right here. It's the C drive, and you can see it's around 120 GB. But in when you connect your SSD via USB, you'll see it around here. It won't be the C drive, and you'll see it's not blue like this. It will be black. What you need to do is right click on it and select new volume. Once you select new volume, just follow next and select the default storage. Then the SSD will show up here. Then you need to also right click on it and make partition as active. So this way the SSD will show up in Windows. After that, we need to close this. We need to go to this link, which will be in the video description. Once it loaded up, you need to disable your ad blocker if you have one. If you don't have one, you don't need to worry about this. So just disable for this side and reload. After that, just need to wait 5 seconds and then click skip ad. So we just wait 5 seconds, skip ad. You will be routed to Dropbox. In Dropbox, if you're not signed in, you don't need to. Just click close, and here we click download, then direct download. Yes, download. Just wait a minute, and it will be downloaded in a second. Okay, now it's finished downloading. We're just gonna install this app. Now we're gonna click try home edition, then agree.
Yes.
Okay, once it's finished, you're gonna click finish and it'll take us to a site that you can close it, finish. And here's the program, so I'm gonna run it. Now, this is the best one to clone to an SSD. It's not the fast one, but you're gonna click later. But it's the one that worked for me. Because in my situation, the SSD is smaller than the system file, than the system drive. You see, before I had the C drive, it was like around 300 gigabyte, and the SSD is only 120 gigabyte. But my system didn't take 120. It was around 100 or less. Here there is an extra files, but never mind. So what I was looking for is a program that allow me to copy the system drive to the SSD without the extra system, because usually there is an extra drive which is around 100 to 400 megabyte. In my case, it's 900 megabyte. For the system to recovery or something, but I don't need to copy that. And most of the cloning software that come with SSD or are available on the internet didn't work for me. Only this one work, and here's how. You don't need to click clone system. It won't work. You need to click clone and just select the drive. So in my case, here's the 1 terabyte my old hard drive, and here's the here's an external hard drive. You don't need to worry about this, and here's the SSD. But in your case, it might be arranged differently. So what you need to do is select the source. So I select this one, next, and then you select the where do you want to copy, and you just need to click proceed. Here it says insufficient space, but it should work. Let's try it differently. Let's select the source is an SSD, and the destined is the old drive. It will tell you the data will be deleted here. You want to continue? I'm not gonna click OK now, but you should just check OK. And yeah, and before you check OK, just click here, optimize for SSD. Because it will arrange the data differently. It's like this diffraction, but for SSD. So just make sure to check this, then click proceed, and it will take around 2 to 3 hours, depend how many files you have, and after that it should be good to go. Okay, now we're gonna swap the hard drive with the SSD. So first thing first, we're gonna shut down the computer, wait for the lights to turn off, and then unplug the SSD. I'm gonna close the laptop, disconnect the power, and we're gonna remove the battery. And then you need to also slide these two so you can remove the back cover, which will reveal the internal of the laptop. We're gonna remove these four screws here around the hard drive. Then after removing the last screw, you need to slide the hard drive to the left and then up using the tab. After that, you need to remove the four screws around the hard drive holder. After After that, just remove the cover here, and we're gonna take off the old 1 terabyte hard drive. We're gonna put it to a side, and we're gonna get our SSD. I'm just gonna unplug it from this USB enclosure. Now we're gonna add this holder to the SSD so it can be mounted to the laptop. You need to also make sure you're gonna put it the right way. And just put this the way it was before. Now we need to put these 4 screws around the holder. And then we can drop the SSD in the laptop like before, and then slide it to the right, making sure it has a secure connection with SATA port. And now we're gonna screw these 4 screws. I'm just gonna put 2 right now, and I'm gonna check if it has cloned the operating system correctly. So now notice the old hard drive, it's sitting beside the laptop, and the laptop is booting right now from the SSD. So I'm just gonna enter my password quickly and check if it's working, and I'm gonna shut it down quickly so I can continue the installation. So after I check if it was working correctly, I'm gonna continue putting these 2 screws to the holder, and now the hard drive is secure. Now we're gonna remove the DVD drive. There's 1 screw and there is an icon next to it. If you remove it, then you can slide off the DVD drive. You can notice here I just broke the plastic cover for it, but that's okay. Now here's the DVD drive, and here's the plastic front cover for it. Now you can see here there's a aluminium holder, and with 2 screws we're gonna remove it. Now we're gonna get our DVD hard drive caddy. Now this caddy has a holder here, we're gonna remove it. You can just pry off it by using these plastic tabs here. There's 1 on the left and 1 on the right. And we're gonna add our old front cover for cosmetic reason for the laptop. After that, we're gonna remove this plastic peel so it will conduct heat more efficiently. And then we're gonna put our 1 terabyte old hard drive in it. We're gonna make sure it's connected correctly with the SATA here. Just slide it. And then we're gonna tighten these 4 screws around the hard drive, making sure these screws here is tightened all the way. You don't leave it in the middle hanging, or it won't go in the laptop. It need to be flushed. So just tighten it all the way until it disappear. Now here where I broke it, but I will fix it later with super glue. Now here's the other 2 screws. These 2 are inside the aluminium chassis, so you don't need to worry about tightening it much. And now we're gonna attach the metal bracket which will hold the DVD caddy. Now you notice here it has 1 way to go. There's 2 screws beside each other and 1 on the far side, so we're gonna put where's the arrows before were. You can see there is some arrows beside the screws. And after that it has finished, we're gonna just slide it to the laptop gently. And screw this 1 screw that hold it here. Now we're gonna take this time before we close the laptop to clean up the fan and the radiator, because I noticed the laptop it was a little bit heated, so I'm gonna remove the fan and clean the radiator with the toothbrush here, making sure it's not nylon toothbrush, otherwise it will cause static electricity and it will mess up the motherboard. Now after I clean them up, I'll connect the fan and tighten this one screw, then attach the aluminium bracket here, and one screw on the top and two below. Now we're gonna close the cover, put on the battery, and we're done here. Thanks for watching, guys. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you dislike it, hit dislike. Also, don't forget to share and subscribe for more videos.